made you some content. Daddy made you your favorite open wide. Here comes the content. It's a beautiful day to stay inside.
Greetings, mood killers. It's Eddie with Marconi, as always. The holidays, you know, where they were kind of recently. I don't think we really talked about what we got for the holidays as far as gifts go. Oh. I did mention that, Marconi, you got me this beautiful box of hand-rolled pretzels. I don't know how you did it.
I rolled them myself. That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. In your kitchen, you slave away. What you do is then you package these pretzels in little plastic baggies, and then you come up with a brand name and everything. And then,
well,
I don't know how you do it.
You know how you roll them?
Yeah.
I have my cats licking the creases in there, just so.
Yeah.
Very.
Yeah, that's how you get it. So you get them to stick.
Yeah. It's a very tedious process, but I found it works great, and I mean they taste delicious. So.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, every year I look forward to your hand-rolled pretzel when it comes to the mail.
And you got me some amazing coffee. And you got this coffee from me last year, and I can't remember the name of it. I think it's Bones, but it's good.
So whatever it is, we can guarantee that it's locally sourced, of course.
Oh, right. Yes, wherever it is.
But fair trade.
But it has, it's really good. It comes in pouches. And this year you got pre-ground coffee, which is fine. It's so good. I mean, I thought
I would save you a little bit of effort this year because usually I send you the whole bean.
You're
and
worried.
I was like, you know, he deserves a break. He's been working hard all year. Let's go ahead and grind it for
it
him.
It is really good, though. Like I really like when I'm looking at it, they have great artwork on the pouches, and they always have some creative names. I can't remember any of them, but it's every single one is amazing. I'm still going through it, so it'll be a while before I'm done.
Right, right. And you know, I think for some reason people think that I love to receive food through the postal service because I also received a box of Chicago hot dogs.
Really?
My girlfriend got me a box of Chicago hot dogs. Yeah.
Now that's nice.
And it was very nice. It came with like 12 hot dogs and 10 buns.
why is there a shortage? I don't understand.
I don't know. They can never match that up for, I don't know why. You can never buy the same quantities.
Yeah.
But then it came with mustard and it came with jalapeno, these peppers.
You didn't
and
get
relish
any,
and mustard any, and celery salt.
No Marconi Foods Jardinere?
I did not get that.
I need to send you some of that. Yeah, I got to introduce you to the greatest thing you'll ever love.
Yeah.
Jardinere.
Jardinere, I have no idea what that is.
Oh, my gosh. Well, it's you know, it's like pickled peppers and things that are in oil, and you put it on your hot dogs, on your anything, everything, salads, whatever.
That sounds good.
Burgers. Oh yeah.
As long as it ships through the postal service, I'm in. Like that's the only way I eat from now on. Any food that goes inside of my stomach needs to travel at least 5 states in a box.
Beautiful.
With a little, with a little ice pack. I'm gonna dive into the gooey desserts.
Yeah,
that's I'll right.
Send you the gooey desserts, whatever you need. That's great. Yeah.
I really wanted to see that Mr. Rogers movie. It was really good.
So the last time you went to the movie theater, Marconi, was 2018. And
is that right?
That's when
how do you know? You've been reading my mail? What's happening?
Yeah.
In my email?
I know that that's right. I go through all of your ticket stubs to any event you go to. I go through your trash looking for ticket stubs.
I see.
The last movie you saw in the theater was the Mr. Rogers movie.
That is correct.
And yeah. Yeah. And I don't go to the movie theater that often either, but I did go to the theater the other week. And I want to review a movie if you don't mind. It's called The Iron Claw. Have you heard of this?
No.
It has that guy from The Bear that yells at everyone constantly.
Oh, okay.
That isn't Shameless.
The Iron Bear Claw.
Lip.
So now he was just in an ad for Calvin Klein's. And the guy works out a lot, it looks like. He's got
I think he worked out a lot, especially for this role, Iron Claw. Iron Claw. Because he plays a professional wrestler.
Oh, I see. Oh, is that what this movie is? It's the wrestling movie, which actually looks pretty good. What do you think?
It's about, well, it's about the Von Erich brothers.
Right.
They're this famous professional wrestling group.
Yeah.
And they're all brothers, obviously, back in the early 1980s. Zac Efron is in this movie. By the way, the guy I'm talking about, Jeremy Allen White.
Yeah. So I feel whenever I see him, I'm like,
And the bear. By the way, anytime I see the guy, I can't not help but think about Lip in Shameless because he played that role for so long. Everywhere he's Lip, I'm sorry.
Oh, he's not the bear? I thought he was the bear now.
Now he's the bear. He went from Lip to bear. Mm. But doesn't he play Lip in the bear? Isn't it the same character?
Yes, I think you're right. The same exact character.
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, it was a pretty good movie. If you're any sort of wrestling fan or maybe were just a little bit of a casual fan as a kid, it's kind of an interesting movie. Sad movie, though. Very sad. It's just nothing but tragedy for the Von Erich brothers.
Oh.
And it's fascinating just how much bad luck this family had throughout the years.
Did they at least win a belt?
Yeah.
Did that family win a belt or anything like that?
They won a belt, but it came with a price.
They did. They won a belt.
Yeah.
But it came with a price. The Von
That's
Erich
what it says in the movie poster. Yeah.
Iron Bear Claw.
Iron
Friday.
Bear Claw.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. But this is the first movie I've seen in the theater in a while, and it was a downer. It was a downer. I mean, I don't know if I'd recommend seeing this in the movie theater because
you're too sad.
The movie theater thinking, okay, I'm never going to watch that again. But it was good. It was good.
Is that what you have to do?
It was one of those movies.
When you leave a movie, you have to decide that if you're going to watch it again?
That's right.
I thought you didn't, isn't once enough on some movies? Like, okay, that's fine.
No.
Because, you have to take it home and reanalyze it when it comes back. Like, that's your torture. So okay, was it, you didn't like it because it was really sad? Is that why?
No, I mean, I guess I didn't know what I was getting into. I didn't realize I was going to be watching a movie that is nothing but a downer after downer after downer. I mean, it ended with a somewhat happy ending, but the whole thing is just nothing but tragedy. And then it ends with basically a hug. And you're like, oh, okay. You walk away feeling just bad for this family.
I feel the awkward part was you posted on your Instagram you going to the movie in a singlet. Was that on purpose, or?
Yeah, that's me getting into it. It's like when people dress up to see the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
You really immersed yourself.
That's right. That's right. But I guess I'll give it 4 stars.
Out of what?
18.
Wow. Okay. 18.
Anytime they release a new iPhone, I feel like they slow down the older versions. And I know people talk about this all the time, you know, like, Tim Cook just announced there's a new phone. So now my phone I bought 3 years ago, suddenly it's 10 times slower and the battery drains faster. And they did sue Apple over this, actually.
Did they come out with another phone? Wasn't it just iPhone 15? They're on 16 already.
Oh, yeah. They're on 20. They come out with one every month now.
Every couple of them. I wouldn't be surprised. Yeah. But it's maddening because
shareholders.
I have an iPhone 14. And before you get to what you're going to say, I'm sorry. What I've noticed.
Down?
No, it's fine. But
that's because of this lawsuit.
I see people with their phones, and like mine has, let me count them, lenses. Got 3 large lenses and 2 small lenses, and I think one of them is a light. And then I notice on the new ones, some of the phones only have 2 lenses on the back. And I just assume because everything they do, the only thing they really do is improve the camera, which I don't notice. As soon as I get it, I'm like, this is about the same as the last one. I guess I'm suckered in again, you know?
Right.
So, I mean, let's be honest, like, iPhone 13 would probably still be fine. And if you still have an iPhone 13, I'm sure it works just fine. The technology isn't that much different that you're like, oh my God, I can't live without it. So I don't like the fact that like every year you're supposed to buy this phone that's cost more than some people's rent. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, I know. It is. It's really ridiculous. And Apple was doing this thing where they would announce a new phone and slow down all the older versions. That way you would upgrade. And then there was a big class action lawsuit. And now Apple owes everyone $92. $92.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. So I just wanted to make sure I mentioned this. Yeah.
It's such a waste of time. I did go on one for a social media. I think I saw it on Instagram. Where it's like, do you feel like you were violated by this app or something like that? I'm like, well, maybe. You know, was your data was released or something? And so you fill out the thing and you tell them, yeah, I was on there. And then you get like a dollar when it's all said and done. It's like I just had to answer a litany of questions for a dollar.
I know. These dumb class action lawsuits, you know, the lawyers are the ones profiting off of this.
Yeah.
Because they split, who knows, so the settlement's like $300 million. I bet half that goes to the lawyers and half goes to 10,000 people.
Yeah, and they get and $92. Like
four lawyers split $150 million.
And look, I get it. It's free money when you think about it, but it's not really because you already overpaid for the phone. So, I mean, it's a little, you should get a free phone. That's what it should be. A free brand new phone.
I don't even want a phone. I mean, just have Tim Cook come over and give me a neck rub. We'll call
it good. There you go. Eddie, whether you want to or not, it's time to finally learn something on this show. Did you know? I don't know why I broke out in the song. I just felt like it. Sometimes the spirit moves you, you know?
That's right.
Did you know? The first Apple computer went on sale July 1976, and it cost $666.66. Now, wow. Steve Wozniak picked the price because he just liked repeating numbers. He had no idea that it was had satanic implications.
Country, we appreciate it very much, Tim Apple.
Yeah. That was before Tim Apple, though.
That was way before
Tim Apple.
Or was
Tim Apple there? Because I'm not sure. I know that Tim Apple... He's been around for a while.
Was he part of the Wozniak era? I don't know.
I think he came on pretty early on, but not quite that early.
Oh, okay. I do like Tim Apple. I just wish that, I think that's the thing. They want to make him so likable. So you forget about all the other stuff that's going on. Like, hey, what can I just get the RCA plug back in the phone? I just want a regular headphone jack or, you know? Okay. I don't need that because I got the...
Right.
Now I have to buy the $70 ear. How much are the earbuds? Like $400? It's ridiculous.
At least $400 or $500, $600.
I would never get those the Apple ones because I hear they suck audio wise. I would get like there's ones that are way better that you can do everything with. That I don't know. I just don't like giving all my money to one single company, you know. Apple keeps coming up with stuff that you're like, well, there's another reason. And then you look at, you know, I have iPads and old phones and, you know, laptops. It's like, what am I doing? So,
yeah.
But that's not why we're here, Eddie. It's did you know? Did you know? Go off on a tangent. Sorry. Did you know? Sorry, that's the entire show. Why am I laughing?
Yeah, that is the show.
Did you know Walt Disney's brother, Roy Disney, purchased the first ever Disneyland ticket, and it cost him $1 in 1955. I guess that's about $12 in today's money. Now, I don't know what a ticket at Disneyland costs now, but it's not $12.
No. I don't think. Yeah, I mean, you can't buy anything at Disney for $12. Maybe half of a bottle of water, and that's it.
Yeah, maybe a quarter of a churro. I don't think you can.
Yeah.
There's none of that.
It's crazy. Like you go there and you have to drop like $6,000 for you, your wife, and one kid.
Yeah, and I think there's a smelling fee. Like if you want to smell all the beautiful scents that they spray out, it's like, oh, you're going to charge for that. Yeah. Put that in the tree over there. Here's another one. Did you know at some point in your life, your parents put you down and never picked you back up? Think about it.
I knew it. This is what's wrong with me. I need to go to therapy now.
That's right. Yes. Did you know Nicolas Cage was offered the role of Shrek, but he turned it down because he was afraid kids would only think of him as an ogre? And I guess he got his dream because now only old men think of him. You know, you're like, I mean, who even thinks about
I didn't hear about Nicolas Cage. Yeah, I don't know, but I know that they offered that to Chris Farley. I didn't know about Nicolas Cage.
Yeah, it's
all right.
There's another one. Here's another. Did you know, Eddie, George Lucas originally wanted Tom Selleck to be Indiana Jones? Yeah. And he would have been, but he had already signed to be a Magnum P.I. So we missed out on that mustache.
Darn.
No, as Indiana Jones, I don't think it would have been as successful. I just can't see it, you know, but maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah. Yeah.
I can't I can't think of anybody really doing it other than Harrison Ford.
He is Indiana Jones.
Yeah. And here's another one. Did you know the tiny hole you see in airplane windows are the nosebleed hole? It's known as the bleed hole, and that regulates the air pressure in the cabin.
Oh, okay. I always wondered what the hell that was.
Is something wrong? What's going on?
Yeah, can I get a new seat, please?
Yeah. All right. This is interesting. Did you know goldfish were originally green and gray? Green or gray, like one or the other. And the orange ones were rare mutations, but they were so much more popular that in China, they bred orange goldfish together.
So you can buy a green one somewhere?
I don't know if you can anymore. I think they bred them out. Green ones are extinct.
I'd like a green goldfish if I could find one.
Me too. Eddie, did you know in polo, it's been illegal to hold your mallet in your left hand since 1974 because if two right-handed people are charging at a ball from opposite directions, the horses will collide. But if a righty and lefty are, the horses will hit each other. I'm sorry, won't collide if they're righty and lefty. Wait.
Okay.
What did I say?
All I know is I just learned how to play polo, so it doesn't matter.
That's right. There you go. You learn something every day. Oh, wait.
Okay.
Here's one more. Did you know almost every case that goes to court in Japan ends in a guilty verdict? The country has a 99.9% conviction rate. Why do they even bother? Seems pretty weird.
Yeah.
So
yeah, I guess it's not a fair trial.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's what it sounds like to me.
Yeah, it seems weird. I mean, we take it for granted, I guess, that even though things don't always seem like it's great in our court system in America, a lot better chances of getting justice here, I'm guessing. It seems right?
Our court system is fantastic here. You can commit as many white-collar crimes as you want.
That's right. Ask Moon Killers.
Let's help some folks out. Some folks. There's so many folks out there that need help, Marconi.
Somebody's going to listen someday and go, what is folks? What does that even mean?
I don't know. We got to help out the folks out there, the fine folks.
And do you think people that listen to Mood Killers would consider themselves folks?
Yes,
I don't know.
I do.
Maybe. Okay.
We have
you do.
A lot
okay.
of distinguished folks out there listening.
All right. Okay.
And they need help now. So send us your advice questions if you have something going on. It's moodkillers@stayanal.com. That's the email address. Or you can find us on social media. Send us a DM. Mood Killers, I'm feeling overwhelmed. Any tips for managing my stress?
Yeah, you got to give yourself some downtime, for sure. People try to take on too much.
Hire a butler.
Yeah. But I always think this. People try to take on too many activities, especially work. They try to do way too much. And then what happens? They're so exhausted from work that they they have to take time off just to get over it. And then
there's barely any time to crochet a bib.
Take some time out to crochet a bib or whatever activity.
That's
you
treat yourself.
Yeah, maybe go on a walk and just, think. Maybe start a little hobbies on the side to balance out your life.
A damn artisan candle or something and shut up.
Yeah, we're not just here to do work and go home and, keep churning it out. But what I do too, by the way, is if it's after hours and I think, I could go, because, I have the access, I have a studio at home, I could do whatever. I go, I could just do that during normal work hours. Why am I doing that now? I should be gallivanting and enjoying my life. So
yes, after work hours, go gallivant. That's what you want to do.
More gallivanting.
So we hope that we helped you. And if you don't have any time because you're working three jobs, just quit one of those, become homeless, and you'll figure it out from there.
Yeah, that's right.
Be less stressed.
That's right.
Mood Killers, I'm thinking of switching careers. What should I consider before making the big jump?
Switching careers, man. I've thought about it. I looked into it for me, and there's anything that I think I could do that I wouldn't just want to, jump off a very tall something.
And you should be an eye doctor.
You think?
Yeah.
I appreciate, because they always say people have at least two careers in their lifetime. I don't know any of these people. Do you? Like the people that I know that do it. And like radio people, most of them switch to like real estate. And then it's the only other thing I've ever seen. And sometimes people maybe try to sell cars, but that's usually a temporary thing. But then real estate seems to be something they find lucrative. And then if they do great, they keep at it. And if they don't, they come back to radio. So
everybody wants to jump into real estate when the market is hot, and then times like this where real estate people aren't making a lot of money, nobody talks about getting into real estate. It's like everybody thinks it's easy money when it's time.
No, it's a lot of
work when the market's doing okay.
Right.
Yeah.
So I don't know. My advice is prepare to get into another career. What do you do? Take some time off. That's what I say.
Do some soul searching. Go for a walk.
Gallivant. Maybe, do some gallivanting. Here you go.
Crochet a bib and think about it.
Ask Mood Killers.
Oh, goody.
That's right. If you have a question for us, we'll do our best to help you out. Mood Killers, what are the best tips for staying healthy and fit?
Eddie, that's a good one. Nobody is at my gym, and it's still the first of the year. I guess this is the year people finally gave up.
Me? Was really busy a couple weeks ago, and it's not so busy now. I know that much.
Yeah,
I think people have given up.
Why didn't they tell me? Like, why am I showing up? What's going on?
I know.
I'm going to fiddle around with a dumbbell and my walking pad. I don't need to go there. So
Right.
But
The first step, I think, is to walk around your home and throw away all of the junk food, I guess. Only keep vegetables in your house until you hate your life.
What are you talking? No. I always see that. I remember back when Oprah had a show. She would go to people's houses, and they were in this whole thing about, Oprah would come over and clean out your pantry. And I always thought, where are those chips going? Like, that's a full bag of chips. And then, why not just eat them and then not buy another chip, why do we have to throw food away?
Then I get in that thing where I'm like, okay, I'll eat this one and I won't buy it again. And then I'll buy another bag. I'll be like, I'll eat this one, then I won't buy it again. And
the hardest part is, when you're, for me, I'm ordering on an app my groceries. And I'm sitting there going, it says buy again, the button. And I look at on the weeks that I'm trying to eat healthy, I look at all the stuff that I eat when I'm not so healthy. I'm like, who is that person? I'm like two different people. The guy in my past was really trying to kill me. What's happening?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, it's habits over time, I guess. I don't know. Why don't you talk to like somebody who's qualified to answer that question? Go to your doctor or a nutritionist and put a belt around your mouth. Mm. Maybe, I don't know. Mood killers, how do I handle a difficult coworker?
Well, ask Eddie. How do you deal with me?
What's the secret?
It's a lot of meetings with HR. That's the first thing you want to do is tell on the coworker, go to HR, and just start complaining.
Tattle.
Yeah. And the best part of that is you get out of your actual job for half a day because you're in the HR department.
Right. They're very concerned because they want to protect the company from being sued. So they spend intricate time with you. So you get out of work.
Much rather isolate you than get sued. So figure out how to be isolated and maybe eventually you'll complain so much about your coworker, they'll just tell you to stay home and work from home.
Yeah. Like I've had work situations where like I didn't get along with someone and it wasn't my doing. They just weren't a fan of me and they thought like, I don't know what it was, but like we couldn't even, like I would have my production team go into the studio and they would set up everything, like anything we needed in there, you know, all the settings and get the show ready. And the DJ that was on would leave the room and go into that person's office. And then my production team would let me know the coast was clear to come into the studio. And I would come from my office into the studio. It was so ridiculous. And it was clear that it wasn't a great thing. I hated that situation. God, I don't miss that kind of stuff. Man. Ugh.
Yeah, I don't either. Terrible, terrible. Maybe one more. Mood killers, how can I become more confident?
You got to fake it.
Mm.
Really?
Fake
That's
it.
How everybody does. I found that confidence is something you fake until it becomes real, really. And believe in yourself for no reason. Yeah, other than like, you know, you know that you are a good person and you want to work hard and get something done or you have a goal to accomplish and walk into a room like you have been there before. I don't, you know.
Act like you're the mayor.
Yes.
Everywhere you that's, go.
The worst thing is to ever walk anywhere like you're a tourist. And, oh, wow. No. Look at this.
You don't want to walk in stumbling in with Google Maps open, looking at your phone.
Right.
You walk in there like you're Adam West from Family Guy. You're the mayor.
Like you're Don Draper. Walk into a room.
Right.
Like you're the top dog. That's what you got to do.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe a little less hard alcohol than Don.
How many? He said, I'm on my third drink. Don't let me drink anymore. Okay, Don.
Well, I think we helped some people out, and we're always happy to do that. If you have questions for us, find Mood Killers on media, Mood Killers on Instagram, for example. It's a great place to go, and send us a DM. Well, another fantastic day we've had together. Look at that. Well. I am saying, yes.
Oh.
Sums it all up.
Oh.
That's what I say. This is exactly how I sound when I have company over and I want them to leave.
What?
Well.
Let me help you with your butt needs.
Oh.
You know, I really have to get up early tomorrow.
Right.
So,
is that what you know, you go to those parties and there's always some guy and it's like some weird competition of who gets up earliest. Like, well, I've got to get up this time. And you're like.
I get up at 6:30 every morning. Oh, really? I get up at 5:45. Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then they've always got to tell you, I get up. Blah, 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 blah. No, stop it. Enough. Yeah,
You know, I'm not impressed by how early anybody wakes up. I just want to say that. Like, I don't care.
Yeah.
You know, I wake up at 3 a.m. and I go to the gym. Well, that sounds miserable.
Yeah, like,
you must hate your life.
What's Mark Wahlberg doing? Have you seen, like, I saw a list
that
of,
guy's
like,
a maniac.
He gets up, like, at 2 a.m. For what? You can literally set your own schedule.
He needs to get into shape for Daddy's Home 5.
I mean, it's so weird because that guy, he has enough money. He doesn't have to go into a cubicle every day, so he has no 9 to 5. He could literally, you know, do anything he wants, and he decides to get up at 2 a.m.? Maniac.
What a maniac. Yeah.
Yeah.
I know. Like, that just means that your life is too easy when you're doing that, because you need some sort of challenge in your life. You're not being challenged by not having enough money. You have an easy job. That's really what it is. It's his job's easy. He just stands in front of a camera and says a couple of dumb lines, and then he goes to his mansion, and he's like, oh, I'm bored with my life, so I better wake up at 2 a.m. I don't know that acting is
as easy as that, but, I mean, I know it's difficult for me to memorize anything, but...
Oh, anybody can be Meryl Streep.
Oh, okay.
She's not that special.
That's right. But I do think, like, if you're super rich and stuff, and I get being motivated, and I think that guy has always been like a health guy. Like, he's always been in the gym, but it's calm down a little bit.
That's also because he has a little man complex going on too.
Maybe that's it.
We could do a whole show unwrapping the psyche of Mark Wahlberg.
Well, and maybe we should make a special podcast. Inside
very special
Mark Wahlberg.
Yes,
it's
true. Yeah, inside Mark Wahlberg, a very important special coming soon. So you can find that where you get any podcast, and you can find Mood Killers there too. Just search Mood Killers in your favorite podcast platform, Apple, Spotify, or go to moodkillersradio.com.
Mood Killers.
Your taint.